So, you are involved in spatial planning and decision-making. You have to deal with a lot of information, several stakeholders, different objectives, norms, laws, or criteria. You need an approach that is easy to communicate, a typical situation to turn into spatial multi-criteria evaluation. But in the existing geographic information systems, the analysis is cumbersome, not transparent, slow, and difficult to adjust. We show you how to use ILWIS Spatial Multi-Criteria Evaluation to identify suitable locations, address spatial conflicts, and choose between spatial plans. A foreign company wants to locate its factory in one of five cities, cities A, B, C, D, and E. This information is available about these cities. The investor wants a large population for a large labor market, lowest land price, the least possible power interruptions, and the best educated labor force. Pause the video to choose the best city yourself. It's too much information already, isn't it? And this is only a small problem. You see, the perfect city does not exist, and you have to evaluate the trade-offs between the cities. Could you come to a good decision? No? Let's continue. But this time, we will not be using a spreadsheet. The investor wants cities with at least 200,000 people for a good labour market. With ILWIS, you can exclude cities that do not meet this criterion on maps, instead of tables. As you can see now, City C has now become unsuitable because the population is too small. Just four cities left. The investor also wants minimal costs, so cities with lower land prices are better. This is the indicator map with land prices. You interpret the land prices where cheap land of 1300 is good. It gets utility value of 1, and land that costs more than 2500 has a utility value of 0. And ILWIS converts the indicator map to a criterion map of land price suitability. City D is the best, and cities B and E are clearly less suitable. And if you have more money available, you simply change the curve, and ILWIS redraws the criterion map for land prices. Hey, now city A became affordable as well. And finally, the investor wants continuity of operations, which means electricity interruptions should be minimal. This is the original indicator map with power interruption hours. You interpret the interruption hours. Although the perfect situation doesn't exist, the least number of 15 hours of power interruption is not ideal, but nevertheless agreeable. But more than 40 hours is not. Similarly, we establish electricity suitability. Cities C and E are clearly the best, but since C was already eliminated, ILWIS will overrule this map and make C unsuitable because of its low population size. Now, you weigh the two criteria. And given the priority for electricity supply, we can now see that the weighing scales result in City D is the best place for investment, followed by City E. Our decision maker found her answer and now knows where to invest in a factory. Let's make the example a bit more realistic. At the same time, the Ministry of Education wants to improve industrial education in terms of access and quality. Of course, industrial education is also important to the factory investor. If the Ministry of Education had given priority to education quality instead of access, it would have selected City D. That is also the best city for the factory investor. But the Ministry of Education gives more weight to education access than quality. Hence, investment goes to cities A and B. The factory investor decides education is important. She makes two plans, one plan for a factory in city A and one for city B. Which plan is the best? Supply areas of agricultural products around the cities are very important. The investor prefers bigger supply areas, smaller average distance, and smallest absolute distance. Note here that ILWIS also handles non-spatial indicators. In this example, the number of hectares of supply area. If the investor gives more priority to the size of the supply area, City A would be the best. But if the investor finds absolute distance from factory to supply areas more important, City B would be the best place to invest. This is why we say that ILWIS makes your analysis quick, transparent, and adjustable on the fly. It is open source software and available for free. Know that many organizations have already benefited. Learn at our targeted open online course for the National Urbanization Policy of Rwanda. Or enroll in the distance course at ITC. And in courses at the Center for GIS and Remote Sensing of the University of Rwanda. Choose ILWIS, Spatial Multi-Criteria Evaluation Software, for spatial decisions you won't regret.